The Bohemian Club. As you say, the Bohemian Club? That's where all those rich Republicans go up and stand naked against redwood trees, right? I've never been to the Bohemian Club, but you ought to go. It'd be good for you. Get some fresh air.
One last question. I read a Washington Times article many years ago where you had a comment about the organization, and then now it's been in the Wall Street Journal, it's been in a lot of different newspapers, and that's the Bohemian Grove. And back in, what was it, 1996, when you joined as a Clinton advisor, the Republicans were criticizing you, oh, what about Bohemian Grove? And then you countered them by saying, hey, I don't run around in the woods naked. What did that mean?
Here is the before-mentioned Washington Times article where he said, I didn't run around naked like they do.
I don't know what quote you're referring to. I'm not aware of any quote like that. I am a happy member of the Bohemian Grove. I like the folks who come there, and it's really inappropriate for me to talk about the group beyond that. Thank you.
Have you been there for the ceremony with the cremation of care?
Frankly, I don't think that's something I need to talk to you about.
Really?
That's right.
I'm Alex Jones, and I snuck in there in 2000. I'm the guy that blew it wide open
and got the video. It's been on national TV.
Well, I disrespect you for that.
You do?
I do.
But it's a lot of big public officials going in there. Don't we deserve to know?
I don't know anything about you, and I don't know anything about your film. But if you go in there with an understanding, you violated that understanding by releasing that film, and I don't respect you for that.
Really? But we have public officials.
You took an understanding when you went in there that you would not do that film. And you did you have an understanding when you went in there?
No.
Did you crash it?
Yes.
Yeah, and it has no trespassing signs there, too, doesn't it?
No, they put them up after.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, sir. I've been there before. I know what the circumstances are, and I'm sorry you violated the understandings. That was not a gentlemanly thing to do.
But what about the ritual? Is the ritual gentlemanly?
Sir, everything. I don't owe you this comment.
I know.
You have this is what's called ambush journalism, and I disrespect you for that as well. So thank you and goodbye.
You ever been in the ritual?
That's none of your damn business.
Today, our nation saw evil, the very worst of human nature.
They had exactly the same agenda, and that was for bringing in this new world order. I heard George Bush talking at that time. He was talking to Bill Clinton, and I've since photographically recorded it and wrote it verbatim in our book, that when the American people became disillusioned with Republicans leading them into the New World Order, that Bill Clinton, as a Democrat, was going to be put into the office of president. This was decided in 1984. Actually, I'd heard about it even prior to that, but that, as of 1984, they were already discussing it as an absolute fact.
The CIA is carrying out mind control on countless numbers of unwitting American victims. And he even went so far as to say the basic methods that they use in this mind control: hypnosis, drugs, and torture.
Three parts of policy that they had adopted there. The second one was to find a way of being able to get total control of people's minds. And that would be done by taking hypnotism out of the realm of the occult and introduce it as a new science for the benefit of mankind.
Reflecting a policy of genocide either against the Tibetan people themselves or against their culture.
Once I realized I had met an honest, genuine, high-level Freemason who told me there were 13 levels of Freemason above the 33rd degree, and that these people were God. There was no God, they were God. So I asked them about their plans to kill people, and they said, yes, there are too many people on the planet. We need to get rid of several billion, and war doesn't seem to work, so we're going to use disease and starvation.
He knew what was happening, and he attempted to warn us when he left office. He told us, quite bluntly and in no uncertain terms, to beware of the military-industrial complex. And who is the military-industrial complex? It is the members of the Council on Foreign Relations, and since the inception of the Trilateral Commission as well. Made up of the Executive Committee of the Council on Foreign Relations. Now, it is extremely significant that you understand that the first six members from the government, along with President Eisenhower, were also members and longtime members of the Council on Foreign Relations. They believed in that organization. They believed in its goals, which was one world government.
Number 15, create industrial depression and financial panic, unemployment, hunger, shortage of food. Use this to control the masses or the mobs, and use the mobs to wipe out all those who dare to stand in the way. Well, I'll tell you right now, every expert I've talked to is talking about food shortage. And it's coming, I'm convinced.
Well, what were they? Because I'd never seen anything like that. And his statement was that if he told me, I would be one of few people in Madison, Georgia that knew about him. And he says they're disposable coffins, and they were stacked, he told me, 15 high.
Oh, God. Anticristo, 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 Anticristo.